Hey, what is up, you guys? We are back with Season 2, Episode 9. So even though this is a passion project of mine, the ones of you guys that do enjoy it, like, thank you. I really do appreciate the support. Today, we're going to be talking about, as you can see, a little bit of the Sundance Film Festival. This is Chef's Chocolate Salty Balls, but it's mainly a response of how Matt and Trey, the creators of South Park, felt about their film, Cannibal, which was the first feature film they made, being rejected from the Sundance Film Festival. So this kind of talks a little bit about maybe their anger towards that situation.
Why do we hold the Sundance Film Festival here, Phyllis? It's so painfully crowded.
Because people from LA love to come to a quaint little mountain town for a few days, and this gives them an excuse.
Well, to another small mountain town and begin again.
That's not a bad idea. But where?
Matt and Trey are like, yes, like these big Hollywood executives, they're gonna come ruin this small mountain town with their film festival. But then they kind of do.
That's right, Mr. Garrison.
Mr.
The
Twig.
The first annual South Park Film Festival begins today.
They're not going to show that stupid-ass Godzilla movie again, are they?
No, Kyle. These are independent films.
Like Independence Day? That sucked ass, too.
Nah, dude. Independent films are those black-and-white hippie movies. They're always about gay cowboys eating pudding.
You know what? Independent films are produced outside the Hollywood system. They're movies without all the glitz and glamour of Hollywood.
We love independent films.
A film that isn't about gay cowboys eating pudding.
Once again, you have no idea what you're talking about.
And the whole gay cowboys eating pudding thing was just a throwaway joke. But then Brokeback Mountain came out in 2004, and obviously that was a big gay cowboy movie. So they're like, you know, like, if they start eating pudding, then we deserve a check because we came up with that idea.
Will you tell Spielberg he can kiss my ass?
Wow, look at this, Johnson. Traffic jams at every intersection.
Not my girlfriend.
Sick, Kenny.
Damn, dude, look at all these people.
Kenny's always the kid that has more of the adult jokes or that understands, like, more of the adult stuff.
Now I'm gonna sell some of my famous cookies to these Hollywood types and make them mint.
What kind of cookies? Calm down, Tubby.
They're little cookies with, and I call them fudgems.
Fudgems.
I want a fudgem.
And I've also got my double chocolate cookies. Fudge this.
Oh, look, one of the natives is selling local food wares. How quaint.
This is why I came to Italy, to get away from LA and become one with a more simple culture.
Even though this is in 1998, the same things being said today.
Tofu or steamed celery?
Huh? I would kill.
Steamed celery sounds horrible, I have to say.
Cute sign, though.
Cute sign, though.
Dad, I have two tickets for the opening film of the festival. Would you like to come with me?
Shut up, Carmen. I mean, since we have to write a paper on a film anyway.
Stindy.
If she holds his hand in that theater, it'll be all over.
It'll be all over.
Who are you to judge my womanly soul? Here is the goddess truth of my womanly being.
You are my blossom. My flame.
Her shirt saying Lilith Fair, I think, is like a music festival, but you know, I'm on my has-been hotel streak right now.
Clearly now the rain is gone.
I just cut, and there's just a big black lipstick mark.
It's just all over it.
Yeah, it's been ripped to shreds.
To shreds, you say?
To shreds, you say?
Booba, you need to get to bed, it's late!
I'm Poopies, Ma!
Hurry up!
Oh, Mr. Hanky's coming back.
Citizens of Los Angeles are arriving in droves for the town's first annual film festival. Small, quiet mountain community where nothing out of the ordinary ever really happens, except for the occasional complete destruction of the entire town.
Yeah, except for the occasional complete destruction of the entire town that happens every other week.
It was him, dude. I tell you, it was Mr. Hanky.
Wait, I thought Mr. Hanky only came at Christmas time.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure it was him.
Why didn't we think of it sooner? This town still has some charm.
I wonder if these two people were caricatures of someone. I don't know for sure if they did, and I've tried to research as much as I could. There's very limited things about season two.
Like termites, we will move this film festival from town to town until we have used it up, until every quiet mountain town is like Los Angeles.
Why? Why would we do such a thing?
Because we have to live in LA, and if we can't live in quiet, simple, peaceful mountain towns,
and no one
will.
Can.
I call them Chef's Salted Chocolate Balls.
Salted chocolate balls. They're all different sizes, too.
There it is again.
Oh, Mr. Hanky wants one. He's like, I want one, guys. Give me one.
Dude, how do you tell if a piece of poo is in trouble?
Yeah, for real.
Go to the sewer, dude. Of course, the sewer. That must be where he is. Come on.
That's also where the It Clown is, though.
Hey, everybody, have you seen my balls? They're big and salty and brown. If you ever need a quick...
Put them in your mouth and suck them and suck them.
Ah, man, it smells like ass down here. Of course it smells like ass, retard. It's a sewer.
Oh, it's Garrison.
Hello, children.
What are you doing down in the sewer with a bunch of snorkel stuff on?
Oh, I was just hanging out.
Hanging out.
Children, do you know how to file a police report?
No.
Good. See you in school.
See you in school.
What the hell are we, the Goonies? Yeah, we're the Goonies, Cartman.
Yeah, we're the Goonies.
The fat kid. Okay, that does it. Screw
you guys, I'm going home. He's in a little fry container.
Hey,
Mr. Hanky.
Have you all been brushing behind your teeth?
Yes.
And using dental floss?
Yes.
And washing behind your ears?
Yes. No.
What's the matter, Mr. Hanky? Are you sick?
You know who asked me to brush and floss? Mr. Hanky. You know who didn't? My parents. Who's a better role model here? A piece of poo? My parents. A piece of poo? My parents.
That's why you got a cold?
That's why, Cal. That's why.
That's why, Cal. That's why.
I need you boys to go for me.
Don't worry, Mr. Hanky. We'll go tell everyone. Come on, guys.
Change your sheets once a week.
It's like he's just got a lot of good tips.
Mr. Hanky is getting sick because South Park has become overcrowded with people who eat health food.
What's a Mr. Hanky?
Ego system is all out of whack because of all
his ecosystem.
If you don't all leave and go home soon, Mr. Hanky's gonna die.
This could be the next Free Willy.
Great pitch, son. How much do you want for it?
Huh?
Does it have?
They just want to make a movie now.
Or lovable turtle. This could be a great summer movie.
Can we put a monkey in it?
The Mr. Hanky story. Is Harrison Ford available for a fall pick?
Keanu Reeves.
Matt Damon.
Fred Savage.
Fred Savage. When you do go to Hollywood, in theory, and like you're bringing your story to them, I'm like, yeah, so we hear it's like a great story about this, but like, what if we added this person? What if we added a monkey? Like, can we make it more fun? Can we make it more interesting, more marketable?
In honor of the South Park people who have welcomed us, we are going to build a Hollywood Planet restaurant right here where this
Hollywood Planet. We don't need to read. We don't need books.
Mr. Hanky.
And it's like the Phantom of the Opera. Got this big accordion and the candles. I would say all the candles, but it's like two candelabras. Pooping?
They thought I was pitching a movie.
Oh. I see.
We only have one option. I gotta take you to the surface.
I can't. The sun will dry me out.
It's the only way to prove to them that you're real.
But I won't last long up above.
I love that Wendy's a movie buff, because I am too.
Mr. Hanky, I can't go on anymore.
They already made it. That's wild.
No, I'm not leaving without you.
Mr. Hanky's a monkey.
This together, and we're gonna finish it together.
I always thought death was something glorious, but now I know that it's not.
It's going over really well. People are going to be knocking my door down to get you.
Who the hell cast Tom Hanks in this? Tom Hanks can't act his way out of a nutsack.
I think it's funny that they crap on Tom Hanks. The fact that he is a famous actor, that some people would say that he would be able to act.
It sure is dry.
It's just all covered up.
The people of my town are a little upset. I don't think we realized what an impact this festival would have on our town.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
We have contracts. You try to pull out now, we'll sue your little town for every penny it's got. But thanks so much for the hard work.
It's like, we just do not care about your little town.
2 million, minus your agent's fee, minus your lawyer's fee, minus my fee, and with publicity and taxes taken out, you get $3. That's more than most people in your position make, trust me.
That's another part of Hollywood, especially now. I know it's become just like, it's harder for us lay people in the world to get jobs. It's also harder for people in Hollywood to keep their status without continuously working like they used to. Because, you know, you gotta pay this person, you gotta pay that person, and then you end up not having a whole lot left. But to that I say, you can go work at Starbucks or McDonald's. You know, maybe you could stop eating avocado toast. Maybe those things would help you when you're getting your movie roles to maybe save a little bit of money.
You can't die, Mr. Hanky. You can't.
He's just so gray.
Closer. Closer. Closer.
What is it, Mr. Hanky?
Skywalker.
No.
Wait.
What is it, Mr. Hanky?
Come closer.
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 When you were sleeping, I put myself in your mouth and had my friend take a picture.
Oh.
Okay. Duck race, mash, poo.
If I vicariously. He loves you.
Let's get him to ICU.
No! No! Are you gonna be okay, dude? I'm here for you.
Hi, Stan. Ready to go see another movie?
Okay.
Okay. Here's the gay cowboys with pudding. I mean, this looks just like Brokeback Mountain. But, like, I've never even seen Brokeback Mountain. I know what it's about. It's just so silly. Him in his bed. He's so tiny. And he's got, like, all the transfusions in him, too. He's in bad shape, then.
Here, I'll give him one of my salty balls to take with him to Poo Heaven.
To Poo Heaven. That'll help
Come
him out.
On, let's go.
Mr. Hanky?
Delicious.
My salty chocolate balls must have rejuvenated him.
You got the best balls in the whole world, Chef. And Mr. Hanky and me t-shirts.
And Eric is still trying to make a dollar. Like, it's just Tom Hanks with a monkey.
I give you
Planet Hollywood.
South Park.
I brought him to show you.
Oh, not this again.
Behold, Mr. Hanky.
Anyway. This
anyway.
Folks, please. Little towns like this simply aren't meant for big events. We love having visitors, but golly, too many of you is hurting our ecosystem. Film festivals shouldn't be about what celebrities are coming or what film is going to get showed. It should be about people getting together and watching movies, and about people who can never get their movie seen having a chance to have it watched, if only once. Well, let's forget about lawyers and agents and studios and celebrities. Let's forget all those things for just a while and just watch some new art.
I think we've definitely got to the point where it's just like remake after remake. It has kind of become like, are we just trying to make what would be profitable, or are we actually hiring people that have stories that they want to tell? Just puts a bunch of them in it.
Thanks, Chef. Your big chocolate balls are just the trick.
And this is like a whole Sorcerer's Apprentice scene. Which is wild, because Mr. Hanky has a lot of power. This is quite a bit here. It's a lot of poop, at least.
Oh my god!
Yeah. Oh.
No! It smells!
Come on! The poo is coming!
It's drowning. But to clean all this up, though.
Gosh, I guess I don't know my own strength.
Guess not.
Hooray.
Hooray.
Yeah, now all we have is a town covered in shit. This is much better.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't have...
Cow.
Kisses.
Kisses. The reason that the little poop splotches look so realistic is I think it was, like they said, they actually took like fudge and they would smear it on paper and like copy it into the system to make it look more realistic, because they really did like holding on to that cut out, pasted together aesthetic. Alrighty guys, that was all for that episode. I hope you enjoyed watching it with me. I enjoyed watching it with you, and I hope you guys have a great rest of the day.